Welcome all of you again. In the previous cases, my thrower, the javelin thrower, whether the basketball player, whether anyone, it is at the ground. And from that, he just moves throws something that is the ball, or throws sometime himself in the case of high jump or long jump in case of... So whatever be it, all the actions are taking place from the ground. And he just throws himself with a velocity u, and this u at a gradient angle alpha. But now the thrower, okay? Now the thrower who have a particle in his hand, it may be javelin, it may be ball, it may be anything. So if he has a particle in his hand, so in how many ways he can throw? Number one. If I say it is the x-axis, the horizontal, if I say the horizontal level, if I take this is the x-axis and this is the ground level. Okay, so from here, if he throws the particle now like this, then it will reach the ground here. And now what he have done, if we throw the particle within velocity u by making an angle alpha with the horizontal level, not with the ground, but with the horizontal level, and this is the angle of inclination. And after that, he also can throw this parallel to that of the horizontal level, parallel to that of the ground. At that time, the motion will be somehow like this. It will reach here. This is our event number one, we can say, and this is our event number two. And another event may be possible, that he throws this particle by making an angle, say beta, with the horizontal level. So the particle can reach the target here, reach the ground here. So this is the event three. So these three events are possible here, okay? If he has a particle or something in his hand, he can throw in these three possible ways. So let us take the first one, that is, if he throws the particle with an angle alpha, with an angle alpha with the horizontal level, with an initial velocity u. So if he throws with this angle, so one thing is clear, before doing anything, we will go for the calculation, all of these things before doing anything. I want to tell you that from here to here, if I just omit this one, if I just omit this one, from here to here, it is very simple, and it is just similar to that of the projectile motion that we have discussed before. That is, from here to here, it reached here. Okay, so if I apply that concept here, then obviously at that moment, it will be u. Okay, that we have also find it out. It will be u, and at that moment he makes an angle, the same angle alpha as that of the angular projection, because we know that if I say this level, this is the ground, when the particle again striking the ground, its velocity is u, and its angle of projection, the angle made by the ground, is same as that of the angle of projection. Now here, what thing is added here, that the particle is again moving up to this. So if it is again moving up to this, obviously it is under the acceleration, that is, if I say it is the u cos alpha horizontal, and it is u sin alpha. So if I continue our previous knowledge, from the previous knowledge, if I continue this thing, then u cos alpha will not need change, because it is perpendicular to that of the acceleration due to gravity. If I say it is the x-axis, and if I say it is the o, then it will be the positive y-axis and it is the negative y-axis, if since the particle is moving along now the negative y-axis, and the acceleration due to gravity is again here all the time. It is minus of g j cap. So again, this u sin alpha is under the effect of this minus g. u sin alpha is negative since it is moving along the negative y-axis and acceleration is also negative along the negative y-axis. So basically this negative velocity actually precludes each other, and here the velocity u sin alpha will increase again, but this u cos alpha remains the same. So if I say that from here to here, the if he is at a height, it may be a tree, it may be a rooftop, it may be a minaret, it may be a tower, whatever be it, and that height is h. And now I have to find out that what time is taken by the particle in reaching here. So if I want to write down this thing, this distance capital H, obviously along the negative y-axis, so it is minus h, and it will be u sin alpha, and u sin alpha is again along the negative y-axis, so it is minus u sin alpha. And say after the time for in reaching from here to here, we say the time taken by it t3. Because why I take t3? Because I want to say there, from here to here, that is a t1, from here to the maximum height, from the point of projection to maximum, the time taken by the particle is u sin alpha divided by g, time of ascent, and the time of descent from the maximum height to the again coming to the same level. Now we cannot say the ground because it is not the ground. The time of descent is u sin alpha divided by g. So synchronously we say that is t3. So it will be u sin alpha t3 plus 1 by 2, the acceleration is minus g into t3 square. So this is the thing. Okay, so obviously here, from here we have understood that if this u sin alpha is given, h is given, then g is a constant, then this is basically a quadratic equation of time. Okay, and if I want to write down it properly, then it will be 1 by 2 into g t3 square, coefficient of t3 square, time square, plus u sin alpha into t3, coefficient of t, plus the constant term. If I take it from here, no, the minus the constant term, that is minus h. So ax square plus bx plus c in this form. So if I want to find out the t3 here, so it will be minus of u sin alpha, that is minus b, plus minus, we know that b square minus 4ac, b square is u sin alpha whole square minus of 4a, a is 1 by 2g, and c is minus h divided by 2a, so 2 into 1 by 2 into g. Clear? So from here if I write down this thing, then it will be minus of u sin alpha, 2 and half cancels out, so it will be minus u sin alpha by g, plus minus 1 by g root over of u sin alpha whole square, this thing is obviously 2, so plus of 2 g capital H, plus of 2 g capital H. So this is the thing. So this is the quadratic equation, and obviously from here we have to omit this negative sign because the time cannot be negative. So we have to consider only the positive time, positive sign, and that will give the t3, minus of u sin alpha divided by g, plus of 1 by g u sin alpha whole square 2gh. I know this term is something looks like it is familiar to us. Okay, so let us say when the particle reach here, at that time this will be u cos alpha as it is maintained, and we say this component is b. Okay, we say this is v of y, that is y component, and this is v of x, and this is the velocity v. So if I want to write down what is the velocity vector when it strikes the ground, it will be, I want to say that is vx I cap minus of vy j cap, because it is along the negative y axis. Okay, so from here vx is obviously constant, it will not change, and it will be u cos alpha I cap. So we get this idea from here, but we have to find out the vy. So how we can find the vy? We know that the formula is vy square minus of vy square, because along the negative y axis, and the initial velocity from where it starts, we can say it is the minus of u sin alpha whole square plus of 2 into minus of g into minus of h. Okay, so from here it will be vy square equal to u sin alpha whole square, u sin alpha whole square plus 2gh. Okay, so if I take this square root over it, then vy equal to root over of vy equal to root over of u sin alpha whole square plus 2gh. So term which is familiar, it is basically nothing but the y component of the velocity. Okay, so if we allow me to write, then just say minus of u sin alpha. What is it? Minus of u sin alpha is nothing but the u component of velocity when it initiates the motion. That is, I want to say here, that is the minus of u sin alpha, we can say that is the y component of velocity, and plus of vy divided by g. So the very beautiful equations come. Okay, another equation of motions is left here. Let us allow me to write down, and after that we will find some path, we get some similarities from here. That is the vy, that is the vy equal to uy. Okay, vy is negative, uy is negative. Okay, ui is negative, and it is minus of g into t3. So from here vy, what is the value of vy? It is vy, and it will be ui, and it is g t3. So from here we can find out that is t3 equal to vy minus of ui, that which here has a negative sign that I have omitted. So from here we have get these equations, and if we know the initial velocities, that is the u and the angle of projection with which it projected, that is, I am talking about this u and alpha, if we have, and if we know the height of the minaret of the tower or whatever be it, then we can easily find out the time. Okay, that is, it is depending on u and alpha and capital H. So if you know the u, alpha and h, that is the initials, that is the through which initial velocity is projected, and the angle of projection it is projected, and the height from which it is projected, we can easily find out after which time it will reach the ground from that level. Okay, so if I take the total time, that from here to again reach here, so this is the total time of flight now. That is the total time of flight now. So if I calculate total time of flight for the first case, total time of flight, that is from the angle of projection to when it reaches the ground, that is capital T equal to T1 plus T2 plus T3. T1 is u sin alpha by g, T2 is u sin alpha by g, and T3 that just we have seen, that is the plus minus, we can say write down the minus of u sin alpha divided by g, minus of u sin alpha divided by g plus of 1 by g into, we can say it is Vy, y component of it. So one thing will be cancels out. So this thing will become, the total time is u sin alpha plus Vy divided by g. So we can see u sin alpha is nothing but the y component. So y component Uy plus Vy, Uy plus Vy divided by g. So this is the total time of flight. Okay. Now, if I want to calculate the total horizontal distance covered, that is the range here. Total horizontal distance covered. So from here to here, we know from the previous. From here to here, we know from the previous, that is, it is u square sine 2 alpha divided by g. That is the expression of the range. Obviously, if it, and this horizontal distance is covered from here to here. So we have to calculate this extra one. We can see it is r prime. R we know. We know this r, and we have to calculate this r prime. If the particle again continues with this motion, if the particle again continues with this velocity u cos alpha, then what it will be? So if you allow me to write, then the total range, if I say this is the r total, which is basically equal to r plus r prime. What is r? R is u square sine 2 alpha divided by g. Okay. And the new addition is u cos alpha into T3. So if I know T3, then obviously we can write down this thing. And if I find out, able to find out the T3, that is the T3, we can obviously find out this thing. Okay. So this is the thing. Vy can be find out from u alpha and capital H. If Vy is find out, if u and alpha, that is the u sin alpha, u and alpha, we can find out the Ey easily, we can find out T3. If we find out T3, we can get a total time of flight, we can get a total time of flight and also the range. So this is nothing but the new. If we have the previous knowledge of the projectile, of the ground projectile, ground based projectile, then we can easily calculate this thing. Now let us move for the event 2. That is, the particle is now thrown with an initial velocity u. Okay, now just try to look at this thing very carefully. I draw it in another page and try to look at this thing very carefully. Another you have to need not to do any other calculation. So here it is. If I try to look at this thing, if it is thrown with an initial velocity u, just think, it is the half of the projectile, is it or not? That the, it is somehow, it is looking like this. If you look it very carefully, if you look it that the capital H is nothing but the maximum height attained by the particle if it is thrown from here. This is the maximum height attained by the particle. So it is the half of next part when the particle is accelerated. It is something like that. So start this analyzing. So here, if I say ux equal to u, the x component of the initial velocity is u, and the y component of initial velocity, if I want to write, there is no component here, so we can say it is u cos 90 degree mathematically, and it is 0. If I want to write down the acceleration along the x component, it is 0 because the particle acceleration due to gravity. I want to again write down this thing, that is along the negative y axis, that is minus dj cap, and so along the x component it has shows no effect, so x is 0. So from here, if I write down the ay, then the ay is obviously again it becomes the minus g. So this is the initial. But when it reaches here, when it reaches here, we say this is the range. We say this is the range. And when it strikes here, this U will change? Never. This will remain as it is. But the vertical component of the velocity is Uy, which is acting in this direction, that is Uy, it gains some value. That is, it gains some value. Okay? And what is it? We just write down this as Vy, and we can say this thing as Vx, so that the particle's velocity is V vector. So if I want to write down the V vector here, that is the what will be the velocity when it strikes the ground, that is the velocity of impact, that is V vector equal to Vx I cap plus Vy j cap. What is Vx? The Vx is Uy cap, that is the initial velocity of throw, and Vy, that we have to go into find out, we just leave this space for it. If I want to find out the Vy, then just see Vy equal to Uy equal to Uy, and this is the angle I want to say here. This is the angle. I don't know whether it is applied or not, but I just show this. Vy equal to Uy, obviously, since it is moving along negative y axis, Vy is the negative y axis along the negative y axis, so it will be minus. Uy, which is along the negative y axis, so it is minus. So after that, acceleration is obviously along the negative y axis, so it is minus g. And let us say the time taken by the particle, obviously, this is also the total time of flight. Okay, the time taken by the particle, to reach this ground from here to here is basically is nothing but this. So when this Uy will reach here and strikes here, and that Vy will be this, that is one dimensional linear motion that I am going to find out. So I am applying the case of the equation of one dimensional linear motion. So it is minus of Vy equal to, what is Uy? Uy is 0. So it will be minus of gt. So the total time of flight is nothing but, it is Vy divided by g. This is the total time of flight. If I apply another equation that is in our hand, that is Vy minus, obviously, Vy square minus of Uy square plus 2 minus of g minus of h. Obviously, I think you understand this for obvious reasons, because all of these things are measured along the negative y axis. So this is the Vy square, and it is 0 square, and it is 2gh. So from here we can find out the Vy is root over of 2gh. Vy equal to root over of 2gh. Okay, so if I put it here, then I think you understood this thing very easily. It will be root over of 2h divided by g. Clear? So this is the root over of 2g. So if I put this thing here, that will be 2gh j cap. If we know the value of capital H only, that is the, from the height it is thrown horizontally, and the velocity with which thrown, we need not to bother about the angle alpha. And then if we know the U and if I know the H, we can find out the velocity. If I know the H, we can find out time when it strikes the ground. Okay, so this is very easy to determine. Now if I calculate the range, it is very beautiful equations comes in. Range is completely taken care of the x component of the velocity, and this x component of the velocity will never change, and after that the total time. And we always, just like in the previous case, and that where it is thrown like this way, we get the total time of flight, idea of the total time of flight from the vertical motion. In the previous case, when it is thrown from the ground, it is at an angle alpha, at that time also you get the time, total time of flight, idea of total time of flight from the y component, the vertical motion. So here also we get a total time of flight from the vertical component, vertical motion. So ux is u because it is not changed. What is the capital T? T is root over of 2h divided by g, equal to root over of 2h divided by g. So from here also we get this, that is h equal to this. If we get h and u, we get the range. So the velocity is determined and the time is also determined. Okay, so one thing I want to clarify from you, the equation of motions that we have derived now, root over of 2h by g, that equation of motions we have find out in case of one dimensional motion, in case of free fall. And Vy equal to root over 2gh, this is also the velocity of the free fall. So that's why I am said the projectile motion is nothing but the free fall in two dimension. So one case is left here now. So let us check in the next video. Thank you.